Hello.
Oh, I'm so excited to be here. This is brilliant, Jackie. Thank you.
You're very welcome. We have Brenda Kennelly. I see Kennelly all the way from beautiful old Green Ireland. And yeah. I want to just welcome everybody back to the Global Party 2017 Healing from the Inside Out. And this one, if you're ready, because you've all experienced pain in your life before, but it is what we're talking about today, because it is pain's wake-up call, and you're going to be in for a real treat. So, as I have asked everybody, what song inspires you, brings you at peace? I asked Brenda, and she said,
I said, Yeruma, the river flows in you. And you're going to ask me why, and I'm not sure why, because I just came across it, and I just love the piano in it. It's just beautiful.
It is. So yeah, we are going to have a little listen here, everybody. And just, I can tell you now, just take a deep breath in and inhale all those beautiful notes. That the whole time.
That is just amazing, isn't it?
It is. And it's interesting, when you sent that one to me, I'm like, I know this song, but I don't know why I know this song. And my oldest daughter walked into the room and she goes, oh, that's the one I used to play all the time. Yeah. Learned it in Europe just by, you know, and she, I didn't know what it was ever called, or, but it, yes, it is.
Yeah, I just think there's something about it. You just can keep going with it. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to listen to it to the end. And yeah. I just use it so much. I just love it. So thank you for making me look for a song.
Well, it's a party, right? And what's a great, you know, party,
party
conversation,
yeah.
But you need music and laughter and every little bit of it. So were you laughing when your pain was giving you the wake-up call?
No, I wasn't. I was in a very, very dark space. I definitely wasn't laughing. I am now, though, which is brilliant. And no, I think for me, pain manifested itself. And I was so asleep that I didn't realize what it was or why it was there. So I ignored it.
So just hold on a second, because for those of you that think when she means she was asleep, she wasn't asleep in her bed, not noticing the pain. She was asleep in her life. She was on autopilot, on subconscious. That's what she means by asleep. Okay.
Absolutely. Thank you for that. Totally. Absolutely. I was so busy in life between work and children and, oh, you just name it. I was in stress city. And I think what happened was, I started getting really bad headaches. Down one side of my head, I went to the doctor. They were really unusual. Mm-hmm. And went to the doctor, said I had shingles. Off you go, prescription for 7 days. You're sorted, out of here. And I realized after a month, 2 months, this was not something that was shingles. But I started to realize, I think it was something different. And eventually, after about 6 months to a year, being on numbing tablets, that's all I can call them, because I was trying to mask my pain.
So when you say numbing, was it really just numbing your pain, or was it numbing your whole perception of what was going on in your life?
So it was numbing me, Brenda, as a person.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, I was taking them, they were doing nothing, they were masking the pain, but it was part of me. Now I realize it. It's only in the last year or so that I've really acknowledged this.
Mm-hmm.
So I was taking tablets to numb the pain, to make it go away so that I didn't have to do anything with it.
Right.
And what happened was I eventually got to a point where one, the doctor said to me, I went back to him at one stage and he said to me, you know, those tablets you're on, are you still on those? Because they're very addictive. Mm-hmm. And I went, are you kidding me? You have me on these for a year? A year?
And now he tells you.
And the next sentence was, I think at this point you need to go to chronic pain specialist, right? Which I did. Mm-hmm. And that was my wake-up call in that office, because the pain specialist said to me, I want you to go on a 9-month program. And I left his office going, does he seriously want me to have this for another 9 months?
Right.
Okay. So subconsciously something changed within me.
Mm-hmm.
And I made a decision not to go on that 9-month program.
Right.
Consciously. Right. Yeah. And I made a decision not to continue on the addictive tablets that I was put on.
Yeah. Minor point, you know.
You know, I don't think I've taken tablets since, but so for me it was about realizing, okay, the doctors can't do anything, but maybe I can. And maybe it's time for me to change my lifestyle, because I just thought my lifestyle was so busy. Mm-hmm. I needed to start doing something different. And I did. And I went on a journey of coaching, because I thought, well, I'll change career.
Right.
So I did my coaching. And then I did neuro-linguistic programming.
Mm-hmm.
And it was during that, sorry, my alarm has gone off here, which I thought I turned off. Apologies. During that, I had a profound experience. You know, sometimes you go to a healer or you go to, it doesn't matter what it is, but you have one of these really, really wake-up calls. And it was, for me, we did an awful lot of meditation, we did neuro-linguistic program, we did the language, we did lots of different techniques to where you can reprogram yourself and rewire yourself. You can change your beliefs, your thinking, your values, you can do it all. But what I was blown away that I could do and own all this stuff for me. So I could actually go inside myself.
Right.
And for me, it was about the headaches. Afterwards, I really healed myself through all of that.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really going inward and finding where the pain was and changing the color on it and dissolving it and pushing it out and pushing new energy in and using all of these techniques. That within, I'd say, 2 or 3 months of that, I was totally pain-free. It was incredible. It was incredible. And, you know, so that was the aha moment and the wake-up call for me, because it changed the direction of my life in terms of healing. Because I would have been brought up in a family where, you know, we were never really sick. We never really went to the doctor unless there was something really critical wrong with us.
Mm-hmm.
But my husband would be a real believer in going to the doctor for everything, right? But I was never brought up in an environment where we went natural or to alternative or mm-hmm. anything like that. So for me, it was, wow, there's so much available here.
Right.
You don't have to go on the drugs.
Yes.
That was the big one. you know, I didn't need drugs. I never need drugs. All I have to do is bless my body and my bones and everything, and I know I'm okay.
So let's ask you a question here and back up, because this is pain's wake-up call. Everybody has a different level of pain.
Yes.
You know, threshold. How long before you had the real chronic pain that you got the prescription from, did you deal with headaches?
To clearing the headaches.
Like, but when you had headaches in your life, right? Before, when you noticed they started to come, until they got like, oh, okay, I need to do something.
I'd say 2 years.
Okay. So 2 years, everybody. She had 2 years of notice that something was off.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's okay, because I'm not making anybody wrong, but we all go through those journeys. Is our body starts to tell us something. And we wait and wait and wait and wait. Most people, it's a total complete health crisis that is the course correction. Mm. So the message here is pain has a wake-up call.
Well, yeah. And I suppose even it wasn't until later that I realized that my body was screaming at me. My head was screaming at me to do something different. I was way too all over. I was doing too much. I was minding everybody. I was trying to fit everybody, everything into my life in a way that was perfect and right and normal and within the boundaries, you know, and the boxes. And, you know, you're supposed to live life this way and follow these rules. And yes, I suffered that for 2 years. But part of the 2 years was I didn't want to wake up to the pain. I feel, and I said that in hindsight.
Yeah.
Because at the time, you're kind of oblivious about what's going on. You're so caught up in, you know, I have this pain and I just want to get rid of it. But I needed the tools to learn that actually I could do something with it. Yeah. That was the key, was learning that I had the potential and the possibility that I could do something.
It's like if I had one message and the same idea as what you're talking about, is if people just looked at pain and discomfort. There's a subtle difference between having discomfort when you're going out new, leaving your job behind and starting fresh, as to this real pain that says you got to change. And it is that wake-up call. Like this title that you've given it in your journey is, I can feel the waves rippling around the world right now. You know, it's like a tidal wave that's going on each direction, waking people up to say, wake up now versus when the tidal wave hits.
Yeah, and I would say to people that are listening, you know, if you have pain in your body, so for me, I was up here. I was in my head all day long. I never left from here down. I never went into the space of my heart and my body. And, you know, I didn't meditate, didn't do mindfulness. I didn't do any of that. And some of your listeners may not be doing any of that. Yes. But what I would say to people is that if you're in pain, my personal belief is that your body is really trying to tell you something. It's trying to tell you that you're just a little bit off kilter. There's something going on that you're not listening to. You need to just check in. And I would even say check into your body. You know, just feel your shoulders. Feel your heartbeat. Feel the pulse. Feel the blood running through your body. Feel yourself in the chair. Feel yourself being supported by it. Feel your feet on the ground. Feel the energy in your feet going right up your legs, into your hands. Feel the energy in your hands. And notice even, you know, your two hands, put them a couple of inches apart and feel the energy between them. And when you do that and notice that, and come back into your heart again and just feel it beating. You know, when you do an exercise like that, you're not in your head. You're completely in a different space.
And if everybody that was just listening just noticed the shift in themselves as you slowed down and became present to your body. It actually did affect us, right?
Yes.
I could feel with you, and I was just, my breathing got deeper, and I just went with you as if you were leading the exercise intentionally versus just an example.
And so I had never done something like that. I remember when I first started meditation, I realized that, oh my God, the lines on my face relaxed. You know, I was like, oh, that's why I have so many lines. Because I was so stressed. I was like uptight. My shoulders were hunched. My face was scrunched. Where now? I just relax every day. And so, yeah, going back to just listening to the body. Sometimes we have a pain and we don't listen to it.
Right.
But if we go in there and we listen to it and just notice, where is it? And when did it start? And when is it triggered? Once we start listening to our body, we can find out an awful lot of information about ourselves. And so now if I have a headache, or if one even attempts to start, I will check in. And I'll go, that's really interesting. What triggered that today? Because it's usually something in your life that's off kilter. Mm-hmm. It might be a conversation that you've had with somebody. It might be an experience. It might be a crisis that's going on in your life. It could be grief. It could be anything. But it's just to notice, because once you're aware, then it's really easy to go in and say, that's okay. I'm okay with it. And, you know, once you become aware, you actually dissolve it. You get rid of it fairly quickly. So, for me, the learning about pain, and I know we've been talking about this, and you, when we were talking about the name of this, we were talking about the gift of pain. Yeah. And I went, oh my God, no, I never saw it as a gift. But actually, in hindsight, I was thinking about it and I thought, my life wouldn't have changed or changed direction if I didn't have that pain and if I didn't listen to it.
Right.
If I didn't listen to it, I don't know where I'd be right now. I think I'd be probably... I don't know, I'd be paralyzed.
Well, let's not go there, because no, you're no. right here.
Yeah, no, and I am, and it's fantastic. And what it has, I suppose the gift of it is that it did help me become really aware and present in my being. And it's taken me a long time, even between having it and now, to really come into my own. And that's really only happened in the last 3 years, where I'm really coming into Brenda and who Brenda is. And I'm not using the labels anymore. And I don't want to be defined by Brenda was in banking, you know,
right.
The identity, because there's so much more to each individual than just the labels and what they're doing. Yeah, and I think also it's led me to a space where I'm getting really comfortable just being me.
Yeah.
You know, where before, you know, you're trying to please people and you're trying to, as I say, fit everything in. But and our conditioning happens from the day we're born. You know, think about it, we're given a name, a gender, religion, nationality, everything. It all happens within 5 minutes of us being born. So that conditioning starts there.
Right.
So it's incredible. You know, it's from the very early 5 minutes of when we're born, even before, in the womb.
That's so true. I mean, when my first one was born, she's now 22, I could feel I was being guided, because I was never going to be a mom. Like, it was never, you know, and then it just...
Yeah.
But I remember, you know, really spending that time, because I was already on the spiritual path of observing her. And I was just like, everything they tell you is so opposite to what I was experiencing watching her and how she, you know, she, and then I was just like you said, it's like, if I believe, if I had told her that the color red was blue, you know, and to every time I, she would have defended that all the way through, right?
Yeah.
You know, and if I told her that she was, you know, black in color.
I know.
Until, because, you know, they just, children just believe and absorb. They just absorb it all, and it's truth when you're saying this is how it is. That's this table, and that's an electrical clock, and don't do that. And then we wake up in our own ways, or sometimes it takes pain to wake us up.
It does, and you know, it's true what you say with children. I mean, they absorb absolutely everything, and I try to, well, since I discovered all of this, I've tried to, you know, shift my language and the way I speak with my kids. But of course, they were teenagers, probably. I'm trying to think. I have a 22 and 24 year old.
Right.
No, it was about 15 years ago, 10 to 15 years ago. So they were quite small. But, you know, I often think about that and go, wow, I wish I had known all this before they were born. So that they didn't have that absorbing of conditioning.
But you know, Brenda, I can just say to you, because even though I had a very vast knowledge, okay, my kids were really were Jacqueline out of the box, is that I was still in between places. So I would tell them, you're like Harry Potter and the rest of the world's like Muggles. That's the analogy I'd use growing up, sort of. But eventually they would say to me as teenagers, like, stop talking about the Muggles world, you know, stop talking about how it was or what the rest of the world is doing or what you think, because see, that was still my pattern of how I grew up that I was clearing. It no longer had anything. They didn't care if everybody was watching the election. You know, they didn't care what was going on because they're in a whole other world.
Yes. And that's the other thing that I realize now, even that actually, even whether I do or I don't talk to them in a particular way or show them different things, they're on their own path.
Yes.
And it's theirs, you know, so I can't own that. So that's my stuff.
Yeah. And it's so much fun, isn't it? Going, even just yesterday, I went to say something to Faith, and I was like this, I went, and I was like, I pulled it right back, and she said, what was that? And I was like, that was a mother pattern wanting to come out, and I clawed it back before.
I love it. It needed
to be said.
I love it. So
being present, what would be the three things that you tell your clients or you would like to tell the viewers right now if they, you know, they're experiencing some pain in their life?
So the first thing that I would say is really connect into the body. Mm-hmm. And really do a little bit of mindfulness or meditation, and it's different for everybody. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it might be for one person, wherever they feel in the zone, that works. So I wouldn't put meditation on anybody or mindfulness or anything, mm-hmm. but wherever you feel in the zone, wherever you feel at peace with yourselves, for some, it's up a mountain.
Right.
You know, for others, it's jogging. For others, it's mm-hmm. swimming. For others, it's meditating. I mean, years ago, I did mosaics. Mirrors. Oh, my God, I loved it. But I was in the zone. That was my meditation.
Right.
That was my healing. It was just amazing. And I keep saying I have to go back to it, so I do. So that would be the first thing is to really get into that space and take time every day to find where that is and do something that gets you into that space every day, mm-hmm. so that you're connecting into you.
Right.
You know, people say, and I meet lots of people, and they say, oh God, I don't have time for that.
Yeah.
And I actually find the slower you go, the more time you have. Just, now you still fill that time. But, you know, I always say, look, if you have time to go on Facebook for a half an hour or to you know, go to the pub or go to a movie, you've got 5 minutes that you can devote to you. Because sometimes it only takes 5 minutes. You can start with 5 minutes.
Yeah.
You know, just connect in and feel. Start feeling the body. It's getting out of this, getting out of the head, because the head bit takes over sometimes.
Yes.
And the other thing I would say is, you know, connect into the heart space. Mm-hmm. Because we have two brains. We have a heart brain and we have a mind brain. And what I love is, I love to tell people that, you know, when we were in an embryo, the heart was formed before the brain was.
Yes.
And it was beating and it was sending signals up to the head, mm-hmm. before the other started happening, before the brain was, you know, it's up and down. So we're sending, the heart is sending emotion and signals all the time to the brain. Sometimes the head is so full of monkey talk and chatter and everything that we can't hear the heart. So the first thing is really connect into the body and find that zone space that works for the listener, for you. And start connecting into the heart and feel it beating and feel your body and feel the energy flow through your body. So that's the first thing I would do. The second thing that I say to clients is to really connect in with what they have as opposed to what they don't have. So the language pattern I often hear is, I can't, or I could, or I must, or I should. Mm-hmm. And I always say, well, change that.
Right.
What, you know, sometimes they say, well, I can't do that. And I said, so what can you do? What can you try to do? What are you willing to do? So really listening to the thought process of what's been said and what is going on, mm-hmm. and listen to the pattern of your language, because it's not just the actions and the behaviors, it's also the patterns of what you're saying to yourself.
Yeah.
So I would have said to me, I have a banging headache, instead of saying, this is going to be better.
Right.
You know? So I'm reinforcing this headache day after day.
Because that's what a banging headache is.
Exactly. Exactly. You know? And, you know, or I can't remember something. My father is great. He's really positive. And, you know, some of us say, I can't remember. My dad always says, it'll come. He's 91 and he's still saying it. And I love it.
No, for dad.
So the language that you use is really important. But mm-hmm. also about, you know, I don't have this or I don't have that and I want this and I want that. What do you have?
Right.
Like, gratitude every day. And being grateful, because we've got so much.
Yes.
And I'm not talking about money or anything like that. We can breathe. We are living. We get mm-hmm. out and put our foot on the floor every morning. And do we have a roof over our head? There are so many people that don't have a roof over their head. Lovely soft bed to sleep in. Hot water. I love my shower every morning. And I go, wow, this is just brilliant.
Yes.
So it's really getting people into that mindset, because I love working on people's mindset just to help them shift it a little bit so that they're talking nicely to themselves with more useful thinking, mm-hmm. and appreciating everything that they have. So they're the kind of things that I would recommend to people. And if you're in pain, it's, what are you saying about the pain?
Right.
You know, it's like, gee, I have a really bad headache. What are you saying about it? You know, if you have a lower back, what are you saying about that back problem?
Yeah.
What could you be saying that would help you in a different way, or that could change your perception? Could you say, this is going to get better, mm-hmm. or it will be 5% better by the evening? I'm going to make sure today is going to be a good day, and I'm going to have the pain 5% better today. You might be able to go the 100%. That's okay.
Right.
But if you shift it a little, you know, just step by step, that's what helps.
And those are great tips. And I know I can hear some of the skeptics go, oh, that sounds like positive affirmations. And I've done that thing about
bring it on.
And I just want to say it this way, like when a child is learning to walk, they are consistently getting up and taking a step. Every time they have a step and they fall down, they're never in their consciousness saying that they failed. You know, they have a vision. So if your vision is to listen here and have pain wake up call, you can back up this, you know, recording and just grab a piece of paper and start to write out, like, what is your pain saying to you? What are you saying to yourself? What do you think you can't do? What do you think? And get present, because if you want to move in a new direction, you've got to have a goal. You have to have, you book the airline ticket and you know you're going on a vacation, but there's still a time between the time you board the plane.
Absolutely.
Right? Absolutely. So it's a process. For some, it might be just like that, right? But as Brenda said, it could be little tiny steps.
Yeah. And I love your analogy there about the plane, because we are great at planning our holidays.
Yeah.
In minute detail. But what about our lives? Yeah. What about our lives? Mm-hmm. Are you willing to stay with the pain? And some people are. Mm-hmm. Some people are, because, you know, it helps them in some way. Mm-hmm. It helps them in some way. Yeah. But if you want something different and you really want to get rid of it, it is to do that listening. It's to be prepared and to be willing to take on the challenge of the pain to get rid of it. Because that's the thing. You have to be willing to do something. It isn't easy, can I just say, guys? It ain't a walk in the park. And some of it isn't. Mm-hmm. But it's well worth the process. Any change that happens is definitely worth the process. There's ups and downs and curve balls along the way. But it is worth it, because you begin to get much clearer and the fog lifts and you're so much freer when you're pain-free.
Yeah. And there's two points there too that I just like. One is things are happening a lot faster. So those of us that have been on the journey, like Brenda, myself, and many others that have been traveling this path for decades, you know, we've been holding this space of great, you know, vision for all humanity to say, to step into it. So it's a lot easier. It's like we've cleared a space in the forest, a path to start down. So there's many ways to go that you'll be guided to find the solutions for yourself.
That is true.
Right. And just when we could probably have a whole other series on this, Brenda, about how when somebody says that, you said that maybe the pain is helping them. And I would just like to say, because if somebody's going like, what do you mean it's helping me? I don't want this pain. It's been my experience that when I was on medication and I had a disease that was never going to be cured, is that there were some times, not all the time, but there were some times it worked to my advantage to be removed from things that I didn't want to do, or to get attention that I wanted because I had this issue.
Oh no, and that's what I'm saying. That's what I mean by, you know, sometimes it's nice to have it because you do get that attention and people are minding you, they're caring for you and all of that. But at some point, it's worth just listening to it and taking the challenge and setting the goal and the intention, to be pain-free. Because it's so much, it's just, and the other thing I would say, Jacqueline, is that you don't have to go down my route of figuring it out all by yourself. Yes. You can get help. And I wasn't smart enough to actually go and get help. I didn't realize that you could actually go out and get a life coach or a mentor or an energy therapist or whatever. I was so busy, I just didn't even go there. But I would have saved myself an awful lot of time. Because when I went on that journey of coaching, etc., that's when it all started to to help myself. That's where I started to help myself. So I think there's somebody for everybody out there where you can get help. So just be open to that experience of putting yourself out there to be guided to get help, because there's definitely somebody out there, and it's different people for different, you know, for everybody, but there's definitely somebody out there for you. Yeah.
And for those of you that are resonating here and going, yes, I so think Brenda would get me and I get her and I would love to get in contact with her, where are they going to find you, Brenda?
Oh, you're so kind. On my website is probably the best place, brendakennelly.com, and or on Facebook, Brenda Kennelly. Just link up, message me, anything at all. And if you want to go online, there is a free 3-day online called 3 ways, 3 days to get out of your head, reduce your stress, and have happier days. So there's some of the techniques in there. Yeah, there are some techniques in there that will help you with the thought process, the whole mind relaxation process. And it's over 3 days. It's free. It's online. Go grab it and enjoy it. Yeah.
Awesome. Well, this has been fabulous. I'm so very grateful that we had this conversation on Pain's Wake Up Call, Brenda, and that you could join sharing your wisdom with the world.
It's been amazing, and I just love what you're doing. I am so looking forward to listening to all of the different interviews. It's just fantastic. I'd love a party.
It is. 24 hours. There we go. So,
well done you. And honestly, my heart is just beautiful. Your heart is beautiful. Thank you.
Beautiful. I love you. Thank you.
I love you too.
And we'll be back with another one at the top of the hour.